I was on a coaching call with one of my executives today. She's got a big job. She manages a lot of people. She's running her own business. And the things we were going through, she's so exhausted, you guys. She's burning the candles at both ends. She's trying to say yes to everything so that she can show up for her business, show up for her people, and she's just completely depleted. Now, she and I have been working together for a long time, and she's got a lot of tools, but her tools are hidden because she's so dry, like she's drowning. You can't use your tools when you're just trying to get a little bit of air. And if you've ever been there and you've ever felt really overwhelmed by all of it, it's really hard to reach out because, frankly, who can you trust? You don't want the people who are your peers to really know what you're dealing with because you don't want people to feel bad for you and you don't want people to like judge you and you don't want them to get this like taste in their mouth because once they sense that something's wrong, maybe like they'll always have that sense, right? So we have to protect ourselves. And this is a really vital thing. So we went through our call with my beautiful client who's just such a good soul. And I said, you've got the tools, but you can't use the tools if you're drowning. We talked about the tools again. And I said, I want you to know that like every executive, every person at your level feels the same thing. Because I think what happens to people who get to a certain spot, they're like, well, I'm up here. Why is this shit still happening to me? And I think the people who are like just beginning out in their business, they're looking up and they're like, when I get there, it won't happen to me. I'll figure all this shit out, right? So I want you guys to know that the people I work with at the beginning of their business, in the middle of their business, scaling their business, like everybody deals with this stuff. We all deal with the drowning and not remembering to use our tools. We do it to ourselves. But we don't have to blame ourselves. So when I said to her, I want you to understand that both men and women who are at your position are struggling with the same thing. And she said, oh my God, thank you for saying that because it's so hard to see from where I am. And I really understand that because you don't want the people who are your peers to, you don't know whether to trust them. So I said to her, look, you don't have to go spouting all of this stuff. It's not like politically smart. It's not smart, efficacy wise. So who do you go to? You have to have a trusted person, a person who you know will not judge you, will keep the container open for you to do your processing, will not take the junk on for him or herself. That might not be your best friend. It probably isn't your partner. But who is that person for you where you can go to this person and say, I'm drowning. I need help. I know I should already know how to do this, but I'm not being able to do this right now. If you don't have that person for yourself, then you're going to probably be vulnerable to some people that you'll later regret being vulnerable with. This is a very hard thing to balance. And I want to talk about vulnerability because sometimes, we want to speak about what we're in pain about right now. And there's something called speaking from the scar or speaking from the wound. And this client was talking about some aspirational women who are, in our society who are writing books and speaking. And she's like, they always seem to have their shit together. And I'm like, everybody seems to have their shit together, even the ones who are the most real. And she's like, well, you always seem to have your shit together. I'm like, yeah. And I always tell you stories about when I don't have my shit together, but I don't tell you those stories in the moment. I have the hard time. I process it with my therapist. I process it with my coach. And then I come back and I tell you what I've learned and I talk about the tools to move you through it. But when you're somebody who's at a certain place, you don't necessarily want to process this with the world. It's probably not a good idea to process your wound with the entire world. It's just not productive. It does not serve you. So how do you know? Hi, Megan. How do you know when to be vulnerable, where to be vulnerable? And you've got to really assess this, like speaking from the wound versus speaking from the scar. So another woman today, and this was just like a crazy thing that happened. I was talking to a person today, asking her how she's doing, and she opened up to me about something. And because she opened up to me about it, I said, oh, I have a really easy tool that you could implement to help you solve that problem. And she felt such relief after hearing the tool that I shared. And she was like, oh my God, as I'm talking to you, I'm wondering, should I share this or shouldn't I share this? And I'm so glad that I shared it with you. And we're peers, like we're just like colleagues, right? So I'm not her coach, I'm not her therapist, we're just colleagues. But she felt like in the moment she could share that with me. But this is a really important thing for you because there's some overwhelm someplace in your life. And maybe you don't want to spout it everywhere because you don't want to seem like a hot mess and you don't want this person to see you in this light. And I really get that. But whether you're growing a business, or you're in the middle of a business, or you're scaling a business, or you're like just about to retire from your business, every one of us experiences overwhelm. And I'm going to tell you right now, this week, I am in the middle of a shit storm, overwhelm, emotional. It's not that emotional, actually, it's just incredibly busy. And you guys know, I don't like to use that word. So what am I doing about it? Like, am I speaking from the wound? No, because it doesn't feel like a wound. I'm grateful that I know how to manage my mind around these things. So I just keep telling myself, everything is going to get done. I'm able to do it all. I can expand time. There is enough. It's okay. Like, I just keep managing my mind around it, but I don't feel like I'm drowning emotionally. And that's why I can use my tools. If you feel like you're emotionally drowning and you don't know how to use your tools, the number one thing I want you to do is go back to what feels good. What will work good for future Jen? What will work well for 15 minutes from now, Jen? What will work well for an hour from now, Jen? Because if you are constantly hiding from what you need to do because you feel so overwhelmed, the number one thing that you need to do is find some space in your life. And that happens when you say, what does an hour from now, Jen? Let me give you an example. I signed up to start working out with a personal trainer. I see him 3 times a week. It's a half an hour. It is not a big investment of time. It is awesome. And I'm starting to see the benefits of it really start to change my life. At 6 o'clock in the morning, 6 o'clock in the morning, Jen is like, oh, I'm so tired. I have so much to do today. If I could just cancel on him, I would get a half an hour back. I could go donut, get some work done. But that's not really helpful for 1 hour from now, Jen, who's going to feel like a completely different person. So I always have to think about what serves my future self. So when do we get vulnerable with people? Well, when we feel safe. And so who do you feel safe with? And if you need to talk about your stuff and move through it, then you find somebody that makes you feel safe. Somebody who's probably not your peer, or probably not your colleague, probably not your spouse, certainly not your children. Who is the person who's separate from you enough to give you a container and hold the space so that you can process through everything without feeling like you're totally exposed? That's the very first thing. And then the second thing is asking yourself that question, how do I find some breathing room? And often it's just one thing, right? Like, what can you take off your plate? What can you say no to? What can you say yes to? So I'm going to tell you one more thing that I said today to myself. A lot to do, really managing my mind around it. What I could use is some help. What I could use, and I don't know what that help looks like. I don't even know what that help looks like right now. And so I just said, universe, please bring me the help that I need to find some space in my schedule. Bring me the help that I need so I can get things done. And what that means is whoever offers to help me this week in whatever way, I'm going to say yes to. So if it's getting Jack a ride someplace because John's overseas this week, I'm going to say yes, thank you, rather than no, I'm fine. And I've noticed myself doing it this week. When somebody offers something, normally I'd be like, no, I've got it, because I'm like superwoman, right? And so are you. But actually, when I let somebody help me, it lets them be superwoman. It lets them show their strength. And if you can make those small shifts this week, I promise you, you won't have to be so vulnerable to everybody. So choose wisely where you're doing that, but stop hiding because you need to be vulnerable with somebody to process through the stuff. I hope you have found this helpful. My name is Jen Liddy, and I'm a business development coach, and this is the kind of stuff I work with my clients on. So please feel free to message me and let me know if this resonates with you. Thank you so much for watching all the way through. Bye.